Do you need to create a redirect in your WordPress website? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll show you three methods you can use to create a redirect for your WordPress website. First, what is a redirect? A lot of people get really confused about that. Well, think about it like going to your favorite restaurant. You've been going there for years. So you get in your car, you drive to the restaurant. When you go to the building, you see a note on the door telling you the new location that they've moved to. And they give you the directions on how to get there. So then you get back in your car, you head over to the new location so that you can eat at your favorite restaurant, which has moved. Same thing happens on the web. Many articles, many website pages get updated. And when they get updated, they need to let people know where they've gone. So that's what a redirect is. There are several different kinds of redirects for the technical side of it, but for the purpose of this video, we'll just concentrate on the 301 redirect. That means it's a permanent redirection of a web address from an old web address location to a new web address location. And it's very simple to do in WordPress. So let's cover the three methods that we can use. And most of these methods will be using a plugin, and then at the end, I'll show you how you can do it on your server side instead. So the first method, we'll be using a plugin called Redirection. So let's head over to our WordPress dashboard. We're going to our plugins area, click Add New, and in the search box, we're looking for Redirection. It's a very simple plugin that we want to install. This is the one we're looking for. So let's go ahead and click Install Now. And with all plugins, once you install it, we need to go ahead and activate it as well. Once it's activated, you'll see an area here where we can click on settings right here. You can also find the redirection under your tools, click redirection. So now we have a really easy setup. The source URL, you want to type in what the old address is, and then the target URL, you want to put in what the new address is. And then when you're done, just click add redirect. So anybody who tries to go to the old post will now be redirected to the new post. The next plugin we're looking for is Page Links To, because sometimes you want to keep the post or page, but then direct it to another post or page. So to do that, let's go back over to plugins. We want to add new again, and we're looking for Page Links To. Scrolling down, this is the one we're looking for. So let's click Install Now, and you'll also want to activate it as well. You see it's activated here. Now you can go into a post. We'll go into Hello World, and scrolling down, you see that it says Page Links To, and you want to give it the custom URL of where you want this page to go. So I'll just type in one of my other posts, and I'll paste that there. And you can decide if you want it to open in a new tab or not. I'm going to keep it like that. And now we can update that. Once you update that, you'll get a note up here stating that the content is pointing to a custom URL, and you're good to go. Now, the final plugin that you can use is called the Simple 301 Redirects, and it doesn't get any simpler than that. You simply put in the old one, put in the new one, and it'll redirect to that page. So again, let's head back over to our WordPress dashboard, our plugins area. We'll click Add New, and we're looking for Simple 301 Redirects. Once we type that in, we see this is the one we want. So again, let's install now, and then we'll also have to activate it. Now, you'll want to pick the one that works best for you. You don't want to use all of these in conjunction with each other. Just pick the one that you like best, that you feel most comfortable with, and use only that one. So we have the Simple 301 Redirects here, and then under Settings, 301 Redirects is where we can go to make the changes. And this is very similar to the Redirection plugin. Here you want to just put in your old page like this, and then go ahead and put in the full URL address of the page that you want it to go to like this, and we'll save changes like that. You can also set up 301 redirects on your HT access file. It's a little bit more advanced, and you'll need to have an FTP client to connect to your website from your hosting account, and you'll need to update your HT access file. I'll show you what you can add for that. Once you've connected to your website through your FTP client, you want to head over to the folder that has the HT access. So we'll go to public HTML, and then we're looking for HT access. You want to download that. We're also going to rename this to old. In case something happens, then we'll go back to it. It's like making a backup of it. So we renamed it old, we've downloaded it, and now we can open it up in a text editor to make the changes. You can use any text editor you want. I'll edit with my Notepad++ because I have that on my computer. Now, when you have it open, you'll simply want to go to the bottom of the file, start a new line, and you can add something like this to it. This is the old post, and you want to redirect it to your new post. So anytime that you would have a new redirect that you need to do, you'd have to go into your htaccess and add that here. Then you simply save it. Go up and save. Minimize that. We'll go over to our FTP client and we'll upload the newly created htaccess file. So that's how you could do it on the server. So there are four methods that you can use to create 301 redirects for your WordPress website. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.